Hey guys, and welcome to my channel. This is Taryn speaking, and today I am back with another speed build. I'm gonna build a small house today. This build can be downloaded from the Sims 4 gallery, and the link is posted in the description below for easy access. You can also search my originity, which is Taryn Sims, and check out my other builds as well. If you like my builds and videos, please remember to like, follow, and subscribe on Twitter, YouTube, and Twitch. And I also have to brag a little, cause recently I just reached my first 1,000 downloads on my builds on the Sims 4 gallery, so that is a milestone worth mentioning, in my opinion. This house is only one out of many of my tiny builds that I have made recently. I suddenly got the heart for these small and cozy homes lately, and I pretty much spent the entire weekend trying out different styles and different looks. So starting with this one, which is a single bed house meant for one person only, I think this house is so adorable and cute. For being a tiny home, it is rather big, but I still think it's quite tiny compared to other builds that I have done. I am currently building on the smallest lot there is in the game, 20 by 15, and the house covered probably half the ground, I would say. I have named this lot Moving On, and the reason for that is because this is a typical house a young person would be buying as its first house, or maybe someone have just got a divorce and they need separate houses. Do Sims get divorced? I don't know if they do actually, but I know that people are dying, so maybe their partner have died and a huge mansion is too much for one single person now that the kids are grown up and moved out. So yeah, basically a new chapter, and this house will be helping your Sims to move on with your life. I actually wanted this to be a starter home until I saw the price tag of this lot, then I was just, meh, screw that. I am using some time-lapse since my try and error is not worth watching, and I am quite happy how it turned out to be in the end. I honestly don't know why I ended up with these black walls, because when I started with this build I wanted to use some light colors, but I was trying different looks and I really liked the black combined with the lime green color that I use around in my build. The kitchen turned out to be really cool. The lime green chairs, towels and the wall light matches perfect together and spice up the house combined with all the black. And I am continuing to use the lime green in the living room as well. I know this is a very compact house, but I thought it would be nice to have a fireplace, so I am making room for that. So on builds like this, I don't use that many doors and closed rooms because I want to give the impression that the room is bigger than it actually is. And I could change the color of the wall to white, for example, and that would also give you a feeling that the house is much bigger. But white is so boring, don't you think? Does anyone watch the Winter Olympic Games? It would have been so fun to be in South Korea since that's where I'm originally from. But the plane tickets were quite expensive, so I am cheering for Norway and hope we get a lot of gold medals this year from the sofa. I also only like the biathlon, to be honest, and I could always watch the biathlon without the rifle. Cross country, I think is named in English, at least according to Google Translate, but I'm not sure if Google and I are on the same page in this particular meaning. Well anyway, so yesterday was a horrible day for Norway in biathlon. We missed so many shots that I literally wanted to cry. And yes, I am that kind of person who gets sad, frustrated, annoyed when we don't perform in sports. But we got triple in cross country, so that was very fun. It's just me and my dad who are into this sport. My brother is more of a football person, soccer some country would call it, and my mom, she likes to win but find it easier to hear the result from us rather than watching the games. So I have to record this in a very super fast way because the program starts very soon, and I was hoping that I could upload this build while watching the games since I barely can use my comp while uploading videos. Well, I can, I just don't want to in case I mess something up as I have done before. And also my comp is working hard enough as it is. So my bathroom will have these super lime green counters. I could never have had this myself. I would probably go mentally crazy over it, but I'm not gonna live here, so I won't be bothered. So I am gonna use these highly fashioned toilets, and if you saw my Norwegian cabin bills, you might remember the shower wall that I used in my bathrooms there, so I am gonna continue to use that here as well. When I was furnishing the entrance area, you might notice that I put a computer under the stairs because I wasn't sure if I could fit a computer in my bedroom. As you might see, the bedroom is super tiny and I barely have room for the single bed, but I managed to place a desk and a chair in the inner corner and I hope it works. I haven't tested a lot yet when I did this recording, so I can only hope that your Sims will get access to this computer, because I would assume it's more suitable to have a computer in the bedroom rather in the entrance. But who am I to talk? When I was living in a different apartment, I had my computer with two screens and my boyfriend's computer with two screens on the dining table in my living room for 3 years. So under the stairs isn't so bad after all. And as we were talking about things that doesn't work, if you saw my video of the Valentine restaurant and downloaded it, you might notice that the booth didn't work when you want to request a table. So on my Twitter profile, you will see that CatLoverPlayer and I have tried different solutions to make it work. The solution isn't optimal, but now you can sit and eat there, sort of at least. So find me on Twitter and see what I mean. So I will have this small front porch with a barbecue grill and a small sunbed. I don't think we have real sunbeds in The Sims 4. And before I have used the massage chairs, but I saw a video before made by Simproved that she made sunbeds out of a chair and this puff. And I am gonna steal her idea. And I also think that I used this in another video as well, my modern mansion, I think it was. And if you don't know who Simproved is, check out her channel, she is an amazing builder. As I am gonna make room for a car in the front of the house, there won't be much space for gardening, lucky me. But fellows, it's yet again time to end this video. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. If you like this build, remember to give me a thumbs up and please follow and subscribe on Twitter, YouTube and Twitch if you want more uploads in the future. You can also leave a comment below and let me know what you liked and what you didn't like so I can continue to improve my builds and videos. But stay a few moments more because the video tour is coming up. See you guys later. Bye bye.